Greetings. I'd like to continue my answer to you, Honor Dogen. You have raised a great question, brother, and I need to provide additional scriptural support. Did Paul abolish the law? I mentioned several points, but only supported the first two, so let's move on to point three. Paul taught only what was written in the scriptures and how Christ fulfilled them. Before speaking of Paul, there were other disciples who preached of Jesus through the scriptures. In Acts 8:30, so Philip ran up and heard the man reading Isaiah the prophet. "Do you understand what you are reading?" Philip asked. "How can I," he said, "unless someone guides me?" And he invited Philip to come up and sit with him. The eunuch was reading this passage of scripture. "He was led like a sheep to the slaughter, and as a lamb before the shearer is silent, so he did not open his mouth. In his humiliation he was deprived of justice. Who can recount his descendants? For his life was removed from the earth." "Tell me," said the eunuch, "who is the prophet," meaning Isaiah, "talking about, himself or someone else?" Then Philip began with this very verse and told him the good news about Jesus. Back to Paul. Acts 9:18. At that instant, something like scales fell from Paul's eyes, and his sight was restored, and he got up and was baptized. And after taking some food, he regained his strength, and he spent several days with the disciples in Damascus. And immediately he began proclaiming Jesus in the synagogues, that he is the Son of God. Paul went from persecuting and killing Christians to proclaiming Jesus is the Son of God. Acts 17:1. When they had passed through Amphipolis and Apollonia, they came to Thessalonica, where there was a Jewish synagogue. As was his custom, Paul went into the synagogue, and on three Sabbaths he reasoned with them from the scriptures. Paul used the existing scriptures, the Torah and prophets, explaining and proving that the Christ had to suffer and rise from the dead. "This Jesus I am proclaiming to you is the Christ," he declared. Paul used the scriptures to prove Jesus was the Christ, the Messiah. Some of the Jews were persuaded and joined Paul and Silas, along with a large number of God-fearing Greeks and quite a few leading women. This is how the message of God spread, brother, by sound and convincing proof from the scriptures. Acts 17:10. As soon as night had fallen, the brothers sent Paul and Silas away to Berea. On arriving there, they went into the Jewish synagogue. Now the Bereans were more noble-minded than the Thessalonians, for they received the message with great eagerness and examined the scriptures every day to see if these teachings were true. The Bereans questioned and examined the claims of Paul. They examined the scriptures every day to see if what Paul taught was true. Paul did not bring a new message that was refuted by the scriptures. As a result, many of them believed, along with quite a few prominent Greek men and women. They believed because logic and the scriptures compelled them to accept Jesus, Yeshua, was the Messiah. There was no compulsion to become a believer. Every Sabbath he reasoned in the synagogue, trying to persuade Jews and Greeks alike. And when Silas and Timothy came down from Macedonia, Paul devoted himself fully to the word, testifying to the Jews that Jesus is the Christ. And this makes me wonder, why does Islam disrespect Paul? Paul's message was that Jesus was the Christ, the Messiah, the Messiah. This is supposed to be what Islam claims to accept. So Paul left the synagogue and went next door to the house of Titius Justus, a worshiper of God. Crispus, the synagogue leader, and his whole household believed in the Lord. And many of the Corinthians who heard the message believed and were baptized. One night the Lord spoke to Paul in a vision. Do not be afraid. Keep on speaking. Do not be silent. It would seem if Paul were exceeding his message, God would tell him, stop, 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 stop. Shut up, 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 up. For I, this is God talking, for I am with you, and no one will lay a hand on you, because I have many people in this city. So Paul stayed for a year and a half teaching the word of God among the Corinthians. Divine protection is another evidence of Paul's endorsement by Almighty God. Meanwhile, a Jew named Apollos, a native of Alexandria, came to Ephesus. He was an eloquent man, well-versed in the scriptures. Another believer who was well-versed, he knew the scriptures. He had been instructed in the way of the Lord and was fervent in spirit. He spoke and taught accurately about Jesus, though he knew only the baptism of John. And he began to speak boldly in the synagogue. When Priscilla and Aquila heard him, they took him in and explained to him the way of God more accurately. This is so cool that other believers with more detail of the truth instructed their brother. When Apollos resolved to cross over to Achaia, the brothers encouraged him and wrote to the disciples there to welcome him. On his arrival, he greatly aided those who by grace had believed. For he powerfully refuted the Jews in public debate, proving by the scriptures that Jesus is the Christ. So this other man, Apollos, also taught the same thing Paul taught. Acts 13:26. This is Paul talking. Brothers, children of Abraham, and you Gentiles who fear God, it is to us that this message of salvation has been sent. The people of Jerusalem and their rulers did not recognize Jesus. Yet in condemning him, they fulfilled the words of the prophets that are read every Sabbath. And though they found no ground for a death sentence, they asked Pilate to have him executed. But even in this, brother, people wrongly accused the Jewish people of killing Jesus. His crucifixion was God's plan from the beginning. When they had carried out all that was written about him, meaning Jesus, they took him down from the tree and laid him in a tomb. There were prophecies to be fulfilled even while Jesus was crucified. Brother, the crucifixion fulfills the message of the prophets. And Satan, who denies the God of the prophets, denies their message and denies the crucifixion. But God raised him from the dead, and for many days he appeared to those who had accompanied him from Galilee to Jerusalem. They are now his witnesses to our people. Jesus was dead, and he appeared to those who witnessed his death. So we see Paul preaching from the scriptures and from the current events they all knew about. And now we proclaim to you the good news. This means the gospel, the Injil, what God promised our fathers. Paul taught the Injil that Islam claims to respect and yet vehemently denies. What God promised our fathers, he has fulfilled for us, their children, by raising up Jesus, as it is written in the second Psalm, "You are my son, today I have become your father." Psalm 2:7, "I will declare the decree, the Lord has said unto me, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. In fact, God raised him from the dead never to see decay, as he has said, I will give you the holy and sure blessings I promised to David. So also he says in another psalm, you will not let your Holy One see decay. Psalm 16:10, for you will not abandon my soul to Sheol, nor will you allow your Holy One to undergo decay. Paul's message is the message of the prophets, brother. Please do not harden your heart against the message of the prophets, brother. Paul recites their message, and we can find their message. I challenge you to honestly look, brother, and see in the whole Quran, is there one single reference Muhammad made which you can find? You want your dawa to be convincing, brother. Well, this is your homework assignment. Do your best to find even one recitation in the Quran from the Torah. I can find dozens in the New Testament, maybe 100 being exhaustive. Can you even find one? We know you cannot find Surah 7157 or Surah 61:6. Did Paul abolish the law? Romans 1:1. Paul, a servant of Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle and set apart for the gospel of God. Paul was set apart by God to teach the Injil, the gospel, which he promised beforehand through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures. Over and over, Paul stands on the Holy Scriptures. Regarding his son, who was a descendant of David according to flesh, and who through the Spirit of Holiness, that's the Holy Spirit, was declared with power to be the Son of God by his resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ our Lord. This is why Satan must deny the crucifixion, the death, and then the resurrection. The resurrection declares and proves beyond all doubt Messiah is God. Did Paul abolish the law? No. Paul taught the law and the real meaning of the law and the prophets. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.